Hey, what's going on, everyone? Welcome back. My name is Will. This is the With Me YouTube channel. Before we get into today's video, guys, if you're new here, please do me a massive solid. Scroll down below, hit that subscribe button, and hit that like button. It's totally free for you guys to subscribe. And what it does, it just sends you a little push notification every time I'm posting some new content out there. But what it really does is it helps me please the whole YouTube algorithm and grow on the platform as a creator. So if you like, you know, the trucks, the, you know, modifying, SUVs, cars, all of that stuff, or if you just want to be supportive, go ahead, hit that subscribe button. It really means the world to me. We're really racking up the subscribers and I really love it and appreciate it. So with that little sales pitch out of the way, let's dive into today's video. So once again today, we're talking about my dime piece back there, my 2021 Ram TRX. As of lately, it's been kind of weird. I've been getting a bunch of comments on my leveling kit video, just asking me, you know, how it's been, you know, thus far with the leveling kit. I've had it installed on the truck, if you can believe it or not, for 30,000 miles. So it's definitely gone through its paces. I have the Foots leveling kit on here, so I figured I'd just make a dedicated video just answering all the questions that people have been asking me. So let's go ahead. I'm going to turn you around and show you exactly what is done onto, you know, the truck as far as like the whole leveling kit. So like I just mentioned, I have the Foots Motorsports leveling kit on my truck. It is a perch collar kit in the front, and in the rear it's just a spacer plate. So it really does give like a full on level look to the truck. And like I mentioned, I have had the leveling kit installed on my truck for over 2.5 years and for over 30,000 miles at this point. And a lot of people seem to always ask, oh, you know, how are your CV axles holding up? Because if you know the Ram TRX, a lot of them have been plagued with some bad CV axle issues. A lot of them have been like busting and leaking grease and all of that. But I want to go ahead and show you underneath here my CV axles. No issues whatsoever. This is on the passenger side, and as you can see there, the angle really isn't all that bad either. A lot of people seem to like freak out and think that when you put like the leveling kit on there that it really gives you like a harsh angle. Really, that's not all that bad. And if you have checked out the CV axles, like the angle on even a stock TRX, they're not always like 100% like in line either. So this is honestly not all that bad, you know, even compared to stock. You obviously do see a little bit of an angle, but I've had that angle for 30,000 miles and it's not been an issue whatsoever. And as you can see right up there, that's the perch collar right there from Foots. I believe this is the 2-inch option. When I went ahead and purchased this, you know, it was right when it came out, since, you know, this is a 2021, I have a really early model year truck. They didn't really offer it in any other sizes. Now I believe you can get them in a 1.5, a 2-inch, and a 2.5-inch, but I do believe mine is a 2-inch. I'll verify on the screen if it's not, but 99% sure it is the 2-inch. And as you can see, I'll show you on this side as well. They are definitely a quality piece. They are all CNC'd out of a 6065 aluminum, and they just install right there at the bottom of your shock, and it just basically adds a little bit of preload to the front on the spring. That way it goes from like a droop up to a level look. And as you can see, it is definitely 100% level there. I am still running the stock 35-inch tires, but if you were looking to go ahead and clear some 37s or even 38s, you definitely want to go ahead and level your truck. That way you don't get into any rubbing or any issues with that whatsoever. And for the rear, like I was mentioning, you don't get perch collars. You get a spacer plate, and that basically sits inside the spring bucket, and then it just adds a little bit of I don't think it really adds too much preload, but I think it just more or less lifts the rear up. That way it gives you the full-on level look. So I think, and you know, don't take this, you know, for what I'm saying, definitely consult with Foots. But if you wanted to go ahead with the 2-inch or the 2.5-inch and you want a pure level look, I think you definitely need to add the plates. Before I installed all of mine, I thought I was just gonna do the perch collars, but after I saw another truck installed with just the perch collars, it definitely gave it a little bit of forward rake. So that's why I went ahead and added the plate onto the rear. And I don't know if I mentioned it, but it is a 3/4-inch plate in the rear. And you can add as many plates as you want. But Foot says, if you add more than one plate to the rear, you need to go ahead and add their bump stop kit as well. That way, you know, you don't get, I think, I'm not really 100% sure, but I think if you add too much, like the stock bump stops don't really work and you need to add a little bit of a longer bump stop. That way you don't really bottom out your truck. But yeah, I mean, as far as ride quality goes, it's pretty similar to stock. I'm not going to lie and say it's exactly the same. It is a little bit more of a firmer ride, especially in the front. But for me, that's honestly how I kind of like it. I think the TRX from factory is a little bit too squishy in the front. It kind of bounces a little bit too much. So if you are on like the same page as me and you think the front's a little bit too squishy and you want to go ahead and just firmen it up a little bit, perch collars will definitely, they'll definitely get you where you want to be, because I absolutely love the way it drives. And I recently just got to drive another stock TRX just to gauge like the comparison between the perch collars and like stock again, because I've had them installed honestly since 3 weeks into owning the truck. So for almost 3 years, I've been driving with the leveling kit on there, so I didn't really remember it all too much, but it definitely is a noticeable difference in firmness between stock and with the perch collars. But again, I totally prefer mine. And honestly, I let the other owner of the stock TRX drive mine because they were curious, and they kind of agreed with me that it definitely rides a little bit more better with the perch collars on there. Now, I can't say for if you're a person that likes to go and do some high speed off-roading and stuff like that, that if the perch collars and a little bit firmer of a suspension would be ideal for you. But for street use anyway, I definitely prefer it this way. But yeah, guys, that's just kind of been my quick 2 cents on the matter regarding the Foots Motorsports leveling kit. I've been getting a few questions, so I just thought, why not make a dedicated video and try and answer all those questions for you. As you can see, looks absolutely awesome leveled. I think it looks awesome the way it is. Hopefully you guys too. Been getting a lot of compliments and just a lot of questions. So that's why I wanted to make this video for you guys. So yeah, guys, quick video today. Just wanted to go ahead and just cover all those bases for you guys. If you like the video, go ahead, hit that like button, comment down below what you think. Definitely going to be throwing some 37s on there pretty soon, since the tires are starting to bald out a little bit, and I can't really wait to see this truck on 37s. It's been like the plan, but I wanted to go ahead and run these out first. So yeah, guys, just quick video today. Like, comment, subscribe, share, all that fun stuff. Appreciate you guys. We just hit 10,000 subscribers on the channel, so thank you all so much for, you know, your constant support, and I'll see you all in the next one. Later, everybody.